I'm Mark Chalero, the owner of MS Classic Cars. Today, we're doing our driving video interior presentation of the 1973 Jaguar E-Type V12 Roadster that has 7,859 original miles that I bought from the original owner. As I've stated in our previous video that you have to watch, that video is a 1 hour long video, but I wanted to make sure I went into this car in full detail. So please check that out. You can check out that video at msclassiccars.com. A couple things I want to touch base with on this car. This is the most special car that I've ever owned in my entire career. I've had 700 plus vehicles, and this is hands down the most special one of all time. I can tell you, as I've pulled this car off the trailer today, we actually trailered the vehicle from Seekonk, Massachusetts to Newport, Rhode Island. I was born and raised on Aquidneck Island, which consists of Newport, Middletown, and Portsmouth. This is one of my favorite places in the world to be. This is Ocean Drive. It's a 10-mile drive around all of the most beautiful scenic spots in Newport, Rhode Island. So I figured it would be a great idea to trailer the car from the dealership here to Ocean Drive today and to do our driving video so everybody could watch it. And the best part of this video is this is the first time that I've actually ever driven this car. We took this car off the trailer. We detailed the vehicle. We did an exceptional job with that. We took all of our photos. Then we took the car to Jaguar expert Stu Jones of Stu Jones Restoration in Connecticut. One of Stu's employees, Sam, took the car for a ride. He described it as like new. He said it really does everything it's supposed to do. I think he was quite impressed. Today is my first opportunity to drive the car, and I figured I'd bring you along for the ride. So let's start this presentation off by going over the instrumentation and to show you how great everything is and how wonderfully everything works. I'm going to go ahead and start the car. I will comment that this car fires up on a dime. I just turned the key. It fired up instantly. We did just make a couple of passes along the water here, so the car has been running for probably about 10 minutes. I probably have driven it about a mile or so, so that will be seen obviously within this video. So looking at all of these gauges here, the first thing I want to say is the interior is absolutely like sitting in a brand new car. Remember, this car is original. Everything in this interior, down to the floor mats, is original. Everything has been verified by Stu Jones Restoration. Stu Jones has actually provided material for the Jaguar Club of America manuals for judging. And again, don't take my word for it, take their word for it. Again, this car is all original. This interior is absolutely beautiful. Looking at these sun visors here, they stand tall. They're very thick padded. The dash, again, is beautiful. All of the gauges work. If you can see with the camera, I'm not sure if you can, but even the fastened seatbelt light is working perfectly. The brake light, again, I don't know if you can see with the sun, but I'm sure if I pull up the e-brake, you can see that the e-brake light came on. The speedometer works, the odometer works. We get into certain things like the buttons down here, the hazard lights. You can see the hazard lights blinking here. They work absolutely beautiful. You can see where the car's idling. Again, that's after driving it for a few minutes. Once it kind of settles down, it gets into that 800 RPM range. You can see the battery's charging beautifully. You can see the oil pressure is super. The clock works beautifully. The water temperature is excellent. The gas gauge works. All of these buttons down here are in working order. As an example, look at the wipers. The wipers actually work perfectly. They sit perfectly. None of this has ever been taken apart. Again, this car has 7,859 original miles. Even the radio works beautifully. I'll find a station here. We're out, obviously, on the point. I don't know if I can pick up any music on here or not, but we were listening to the radio earlier. actually the antenna's down, but the radio is in excellent working order as well. Again, all of the headlights, the directionals, the reverse lights, the horn, everything is in great working order. Even the light comes on when you put the choke on the car when the car is cold. It starts instantly, it purrs like a kitten. I cannot say enough about sitting behind the wheel of this car. So we're gonna take off for our test drive. One thing I will tell you is when I got this car off the trailer, the minute that I actually sat in the car, felt the gearbox, felt the clutch, and felt it around the parking lot, I told all of my employees, I think that's the best car that I've ever driven around the parking lot. It was just hard to describe. The only thing I can say is when something's original, it's original. When it's never been taken apart and put back together, you totally can just feel the difference. My father, which was in the driving videos as we went by, he went for a ride with me prior to doing this right now, and he said to me that it was nicer driving in this car than it was in the new Lexus that we drove down here with. It's that impressive. So we're gonna go ahead and take off here. The clutch is super, super smooth. There's zero chatter. It feels excellent. This is the original clutch. Although it does have new fluids and so forth, it's original. The gearbox shifts beautifully. You can see I just put it in the second gear. The car is super straight. There's not one squeak. There's not one rattle. I'm barely touching the gas pedal. As you can see, we go around this nice curve here. There's no friction. It just is effortlessly going around these corners. The brakes are excellent. You can see we come to a nice stop here. There's no pulsing, there's no squeaking, there's no noises. For me, this is a very epic moment to be driving the most special car that I've ever owned. I had my father in the passenger seat in what I feel is the most beautiful place in the world to be, Ocean Drive, Newport, Rhode Island, driving this car that I bought from the original owner. This car has only been driven about 10 miles in 30 years. And I can swear it feels right now like we're driving in a brand new car off the showroom floor in 1973. It's just truly amazing. Look at these curves and look at my finger on this steering wheel. I'm barely even touching the steering wheel. This is a pretty sharp corner right here. Look at how this car just moves through this corner. It is amazing. I'll get on the gas a little bit. You can hear the engine, you can hear the exhaust, you can see the RPM gauge, the speedometer is working beautifully. It's just absolutely beautiful to drive. Downshift it, shifts beautifully. Again, this is the first time I've ever driven this car. Not a squeak, a rattle. This is a pretty bumpy road out here. Absolutely amazing. Gearbox, the original matching numbers transmission, downshifting it back to third. You can hear how it just flows perfectly. Everything in this engine compartment is original. Even the belts are the original belts. They've been inspected by Jaguar experts. It's unheard of to have original belts in a 1973 vehicle. This vehicle had a headlight conversion. They did an absolutely beautiful job. Nobody was doing headlight conversions in the early 70s. This car had a headlight conversion in 1974. people don't believe it. We have receipts to document it. You can hear again, I'm applying no brake through these tight hairpin turns. I'm letting the transmission do all the work. There's zero hesitation. The engine sounds beautiful. When the original owner, who was a doctor, serviced this car after sitting for 30 years, he only did very, very, very light mechanical things to improve the car in preparation for sale. And he did a great job. He said, Mark, when I took it out after 30 years on that first 5 mile ride, it felt like the day I took it out of the showroom. It's that nice. I really can't say enough about it. So again, I just downshifted it to second gear. You can see where the speedometer is. We're turning miles as we're driving, obviously. No hiccups, no imperfections. Nothing. This is truly the nicest classic car that I have ever driven in my entire career. I don't want to sound like a salesperson. I'm a true car enthusiast. Yes, I own a classic car dealership. Yes, I want to sell this car. But sometimes you just got to tell it like it is. This is one of those situations where you just have to feel it to understand it. The new owner who gets this car is in for a serious treat. To step back into 1973 and to have a car that has never been taken apart, that has such low miles on it, this is the way these cars felt, this is the way they are. Today is only high 30s. It's only 38, 39 degrees outside right now. And this thing is purring like a kitten. Look at these gauges. Then look at where the temperature is. Exactly where it should be. The fuel gauge is working perfectly. The clock, look at the oil pressure, the battery. I mean, just look at this car. It's unbelievable. We're gonna come up over a hill here into this really nice turn. I take them occasionally over the years. I've taken a few motorcycles around Ocean Drive. I've taken some very high-end exotic sports cars around Ocean Drive, classic cars, whatever the case might be. This car is handling this road like a brand new vehicle would. It's amazing. I have to be a little bit careful here because obviously there's some traffic. Look at how this corners beautifully through these turns. What I'm going to do is turn around down here and we'll circle back. This is where I'll make the turn. I just downshifted to first gear on the fly, like it was nothing. Listen to this motor. I'll pick up a little speed here. Again, I have to be careful. Listen to this. Listen to this V12. This engine runs so smooth, you can put a cup of coffee on it when it's sitting in neutral. I'm in third gear going up this hill. Zero hesitation. Flawless. These carburetors were set to factory specifications when they did the slight carburetor rebuild. That was the only thing that was really done in the engine department. Thank you. January. Thank you for coming around this test drive with us, the interest in this vehicle. Well, this concludes our test drive. There's our truck and our trailer. We are going to load it back into the truck and trailer and bring it back to Seekonk, Massachusetts. Park it in the MS Classic Cars showroom. That will officially be the last time I drive the car, my first and my last time. I can tell you that it was an extremely pleasurable experience. This is something that I truly enjoyed. Thank you for coming on the test drive with us. This car is going to be selling on a bring a trailer auction. You have an opportunity to buy this amazing piece of history. Again, this car is a one owner car loaded with documentation, and it currently now has 7,866 miles. Here's the truck. Here's the trailer. We really appreciate you watching and being part of this. Thank you. Hello, I'm Mark Chalero, the owner of MS Classic Cars. Today is Thursday, January 14th. Yesterday, we took this vehicle, which is our 73 Jaguar, to Ocean Drive in Newport, Rhode Island for a driving video. I also did a presentation of all of the options and features. It was a very epic day yesterday. It was the first time I drove the car. I had my father there, the crew there. And after we got back last night and started going through the video, I missed a lot of things that I wanted to cover and be very clear about. So here we are today. I figured I would do this quick presentation. So let's start with the front. What I'd like to do is to demonstrate the lights. I'm gonna go ahead and put the key in here, turn it on, and flip on the headlights. So you clearly will see these headlights are in great working order. You'll notice that the parking lights are in working order and the lights at the bottom as well. Those are in great working order. If you come to the back of the vehicle, you will see the parking lights on the back as well, which are all in working order. Why we're there in the back be the perfect opportunity for me to show you the reverse lights, which are here and here. So those are in great working order as well. Now, if you want to make your way back to the front, I'd like to show you the high beams and show that those are in great working order as well. Everything in this car is in excellent working order. Here's the high beams, low beams. I'll turn them off. I'm also going to demonstrate the hazard lights. You can see the lights blinking on both sides. They're also blinking in the back as well. And you can clearly see them on the instrument panel. And you can see them up here as well. So, I'll go ahead and shut those off. The other thing that I'd like to demonstrate here is this map light. You'll see that that map light comes on. That works beautifully. If I turn the map light off and open the door, you'll notice that light comes on as well. Now, let's do the turn signals. We got the left side turn signal. You'll see it working there. Make our way back to the front. You'll see the turn signal working. And while you're in the front, I'll go ahead and demonstrate the right side as well. So here we go. I just shut it off. Turn on the right side. That's the right side. If you want to make your way to the back, I can actually show you the back as well. This is again going to be on the right side, and then I'll demonstrate the left side. Keep in mind, this car has never been taken apart, so all the wiring is original. Okay, this is going to be the left side. Now, if you come over on this side of the car, yesterday during the video, again, I missed a lot of things that I want to cover here today. First thing I'd like to show you is this remote mirror. This is a manual mirror, but it's still remote. You can see how it turns beautifully, so that operates as it should. A lot of times that doesn't work with particular cars. You will also notice yesterday in our video that this seatbelt light was on. Well, yesterday again, it was a little overwhelming. I forgot to put on my seatbelt. We were just doing a very short video. Not a big deal, but I wanted to make sure I showed you the seat belts clipping in here. And you see how that seat belt light goes out. So it clearly works. And again, I'll release it and you'll see it come back on. So that seat belt light was on yesterday during the video. Some people might have thought something was wrong, but the truth of the matter was I didn't have my seat belt on. Shame on me. Live and learn. Now, making our way to the rest of this interior here, another thing that happened yesterday in the video is the radio. You notice I was searching for a station. Well, I did not have the antenna up. You can clearly see the antenna is up now. Even though we are inside of a building, this radio works beautifully.
turn it on.
2021 Kia Sportage LX.
I'll go ahead and so that clearly is in working order. Yesterday we were out far on the point. I had the antenna down, so I was searching for a station, but I wanted to show that that was in working order as well. I also want to show here that the AC in this car does work. Of course, the compressor turns on when the car is running. You really wouldn't be able to hear that. But what I will do is just demonstrate this knob here. You probably can hear that if we're quiet. I'll try to put my mic up close here, but you can clearly hear the blower working. Again, this is all original, this interior. And you hear it shut off. Now, again, last thing I'd like to show you in here, I think I covered everything that I missed yesterday. I also wanted to show you the wipers. I only turned the wipers on one time yesterday. So again, I'll let them run for a second here to show you. The wipers are in great working order. And I'll go ahead and shut them off. The last thing I'd like to show is the trunk opening. I didn't actually show that yesterday as well, so I'll do that here. This just pulls here, pops right open like it should. I currently have all the information in here that we're providing with the car that we went over in the other video. Shut the trunk. Trying to think if there's anything else that I missed. I don't think there is. Anyway, we appreciate you checking out this car. It's unbelievable. Thanks again.